हेलो,
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी ऑलरेडी फिनिश फर्स्ट थ्री क्वेश्चंस ऑफ 14.3। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड हाउ टू रिप्रेजेंट डेटा इन ग्राफिकली, इन बार ग्राफ, हिस्टोग्राम एंड थर्ड वन इज फ्रीक्वेंसी पॉलीगॉन। बार ग्राफ इज वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड। नाउ वी विल डू क्वेश्चन नंबर 5। वी ऑलरेडी फिनिश थर्ड थ्री क्वेश्चन, बट फर्स्ट वी विल डू फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन। आफ्टर दिस वन वी विल डू फोर्थ क्वेश्चन। इन फोर्थ क्वेश्चन द फॉलोइंग टेबल्स गिवन इन द लाइफ टाइम ऑफ 400 नियोन लैंप्स। देर आर द 400 नियोन लैंप्स आर गिवन एंड देयर लाइफ इज गिवन। अंडरस्टैंड? नंबर एंड देयर लाइफ टाइम इन, एंड लाइफ टाइम इज गिवन इन आवर्स। तो इट्स मीन तो रिप्रेजेंट द गिवन इंफॉर्मेशन विद हेल्प ऑफ हिस्टोग्राम। We have to represent in histogram. So first we have to think what is histogram. Histogram is a graphical representation of data which is used for continuous class interval. So first we will check here in class interval are continuous or not. So it's lifetime given in hours of neon lamps. And second is number of lamps. How much number of lamps? So it means 300 to 400 hours, 400 to 500, 500 to 600, 600 to 700, 700 to 800, 800 to 900, and 900 to 1000. It is the lifetime of the neon bulb. How many bulbs, neon lamps, whose lifetime is between 300 to 400 hours? Maybe some lamps are damaged after 350 hours. So it means how many? They are 14, 56, and 60, 86, and next is 74, 62 and 42. And we know number of total lamps how much? 400 already given in case. Now we represent this data in histogram. If you want to represent in histogram used for continuous class interval. Yes, first we will check they are continuous or not. Yes, 300 to 400 and again 400 to 500, 500 to 600, 600 to 700. So it is continuous. Understand or not? So it means we can use continuous. So now what we will do? So one, we will take two axes, one x axis and y axis. On x axis, we will take lifetime and y axis number of lamps. So using scales and pencil, and we use the graph also. One second. So it is number of lamps. X-axis, y-axis. Always what I told you, always constant terms we will take on x-axis. Constant is 300 to 400. So this one, so it is lifetime, right? Lifetime in hours. Understand? In hours, and what is? And we know, so it is starting from, it is 0 always, no? And it is 300 to 400. So 300, suppose if I write, it is 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900 and 1000. Everyone know 300 to 400, how many numbers? Only 100. Here is also 100. But this one is also 0 to 300 to 300 to 400. It's same gap. Between the gaps are always same gap. But 0 to 300, how many numbers? Here is 300. So always in place of this one, we will give it this sign.
It's mean, it is this sign mean 0 to from here to here. How many number? 300. And all are 100, 100, 100. Understand? Next is number of lengths on y-axis. And we observe the least number is 14 and maximum is 86. So it is better we will take here 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 50 because minimum is 40. So right? So right here, so 14, so here 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, and maximum is 86. So up to 90 you can take. You will ask, sir, here you will not use this sign because 10, 10, 10, here is also 10, so it is. Understand it? And you can now. 300 to 400. How many number of lengths? 14. So 14 between 10 and 20, 15. And between 10 and 15, how many number? 5 number. 1, 2, 3, slightly less than 50. So it is. Always use pencil and scale and use in graph. Next is. 400 to 500, 56. How much? 56. So 56 between 50 and 60. So it is 55 and slightly greater than 55. So it is. Next is 500 to 600. How much? 60. It is 60. Next is 600 to 786. 86 between 80 and 90. And it is 85 greater than 85. I am not using scales. That's why the width of these bars are not equally. But you should make equally. Okay? Understand it? Next is 700 to 874. It is 75. 74, slightly less than 800 to 900, 62. It is 16, 62. Next is 48. It is 50, slightly less than. So it is the graphically representation of this data in histogram. Histogram always. In the bar graph, there is the gap between the bars, but in histogram, no gap. Why? Because their class intervals are continuous. Understand it? And now you can write in a graph also in what you take on x-axis and what you took on y-axis. So you can take x-axis. On x-axis, we take lifetime. Lifetime and on x-axis, 1 unit. 1 unit equal to how much? 100. What is 100 unit? 100 hours. 100 hours. And in y-axis, in downside also you can write. Here is no space. That's why I write on top. Now on y-axis we take number of lamp. Always we will write this one in exam. Otherwise examiner will cut your marks. Understand it? And on y-axis, 1 unit equal to 10, 10, 10, 10. Okay? To 10 lamb. Understand? That is the finish of our fourth question. Second part, how many lambs have a lifetime more than 700? So more than 700. From 600 to 700. What is meaning of it? It is lower limit. It is upper limit. Always lower and upper limit, it means 700 is not included here. It means these are 86 lambs whose lifetime between 600 and 700. It means less than 700 hours. In the second part, he is asking more than 700. So how many more than 700? Yes, 74, 62 plus 48. So you can write. Number of lambs whose lifetime is more than 700 is equal to 74 plus 62 plus 40.
8. You can add and write your answer. Understand it? Because in the question asking how many lamps whose lifetime is more than 700 hours. So more than 700. 74, 62. Understand it? So it is the histogram representation of the data. It is very like a bar graph. It's very simple. Understand it? So next, now. So two graphical representation we already learned. Now we will learn third one. Before the start, fourth question we should know what is frequency polygon. Frequency polygon. Yes. There is a two method to finding the data in frequency polygon. Two method. First method is used by histogram. What is? First method we can use the data in histogram by of frequency polygon in histogram. So first data what will qualify? Always if you want to represent frequency polygon, represent the data in frequency polygon, so first we should have to find histogram. First thing, we have to find histogram. Histogram mean we have to make class interval R continuous. So suppose we are taking this example. It is already histogram. So first we represent in histogram. After this one, what we will do? Always we will find the midpoint of this bar. Midpoint. So midpoint of this one bar. Between 300 and 400 in fourth question. What is? 350. It is. Between 400 and 500, it is midpoint. It is midpoint. It is midpoint. It is midpoint. Midpoint and midpoint. And midpoint, how will you find? Tell me, 300 to 400, how will you find midpoint? Midpoint. A number which is between 300 and 400, how will you find? 300 plus 400 divided by 2. 350. Otherwise, directly, you will mark in middle by the using of scales. So, and after the finding the midpoint of the histogram, we will join these point by pencil. Like this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one. And this line, it is called a frequency polygon. And frequency polygon we already learn in 8th class also. It is a frequency polygon. So joining the midpoint of the bars, midpoints in the topmost, then you will find a frequency polygon. Understand it? So you can write it if you want to note down it to write what is by first method. Join the midpoint. Join the what is midpoint of whose of upper side. Not in downside we are joining. Not downside we are joining. On upper. Midpoint of upper side. Upper sides. Whose upper sides? Upper sides of the. These are called bars. Or the upper sides of the. Join the midpoints. Midpoints of the upper sides of the bars. Bars also you can see that it is like a rectangle. Every bar is like a right. Or you can write rectangles. Join the midpoint of the upper sides of the rectangles. Understand? So it is a frequency polygon. Understand it? Next method. If you want to represent in frequency polygon. Understand? So next method, note down it. What is next method? Yes. Second method. It is first, it is second. Now,
In the second method, no need to histogram. That's why I am rub the this one. Okay. In second method, yes, we can draw frequency polygon. We can draw frequency polygon. We can without using of histogram. Without using of histogram, we can find also what is frequency polygon. So what we have to do for the if you want. So always, so for this. If you want to represent in frequency polygon, so you have to find the midpoint of the class interval. You can write, for this, we have to find midpoints of class interval. What we have to find? Midpoint of class interval. Same as it is. Example number 4 we are taking. What is? 300 to 400 class interval. 400 to 500. 500 to 600. Like this one. And it is the class interval given. Class interval. And when we find midpoint, we have to find midpoint of class interval. So midpoint after, if you find the midpoint of class, so it is called class mark. What we call it? Class mark. Understand it? So tell me, in the same as it is in question number 4. In question number 4, 300 to 400, 400 to 500, 500 to 600, first we have to find class mark. So class mark means midpoint of the class interval. And midpoint of the class interval, how will you find? So always it is a one method. Everyone know, midpoint of 300 and 400 is 350, 400 is 450. But how will we find the class mark? So class mark formula is, how will you find? Look at here, note down this formula. Class mark equal to, how will you find? 400 plus 300 divided by 2. Upper limit plus lower limit. So you can write upper limit plus lower limit and divide by 2. Divide by 2. 400 plus 300, 700. 700 divided by 350. Understand? It means if you want to find the mid of the annual, suppose your friend has 10 rupees and you have 20 rupees. Tell me, how much rupees you will take from your friends, then your rupees is become equally. So how will you find? 10 plus 20 divided by 2. So it means 15. So what is the mid value? 15. So your friend will give you 5 rupees. So always remember this formula. Class mark. First, if you want to represent in frequency polygon, first we will find class mark. Upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. Understand it? So same as it is, we will find class mark like this one, 300 and 500. And same as it is in the question is given, in the fourth question, 300 to 400, this one, it is class mark, suppose, it is class mark here, 350, 450 and 550. And number of lamps, how much? 14. How much given in number of lamps in this one? 14, 56 and 60. Now we will represent in graph. Yes. Now we will not use in class interval. We will use class mark. 350, 450, 550. How many? 14, 10, 20, 30. So 14 is there. Between here. 450, 56 here and join like this one. Points. Only point will. because midpoint, we join midpoint in the histogram. Midpoint of 300 and 400, 350. It is also 350. So both are same. You can use histogram also and this one. It is the independent. Understand it? The second method is independently without using of histogram. Now we will do question number. First we will do question number, yes, which one? We are doing now question number 8. Yes, not 8. We will do question number 4. Frequency polygon we already learned, histogram also. Question number 4, here we can check it. 182, one class interval, 127 to 135, 136 to 144. So represent this data in histogram. But in histogram, if you want to represent, we need class interval are continuous. 126, here is not 126, here is 127. So it is not your in your syllabus for this year. Whenever data is given uncontinuous, class interval are not given continuous, it is not in your syllabus. But I will tell you how to find this one also. Before this one, we will do one or two more questions. Then after this one, in next class, we will do this one also. Okay. So now before this one, everyone. Question number 8. So before this one, now you will need question number 4, question number 6 and question number 7. Now we are doing question number 8 in this class. Okay. A random survey of the number of children various age group in the park, draw a histogram. It is given age in years, and second is given number of children. Understand it? So what is, how many? 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 5, not this one. 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 5, not this one. I think video is already lengthy. So in next class, we will start our question number 4. Understand it? Question number 4, question number 6 and question number 7 we will do. But today homework is that question number 5 you will do yourself, and question number 5 also you will find frequency polygon also. And you have one more question. Which one? Example number 7. Homework. You will do example number 7 in your notebook. Understand it? Example number 7. And example number 6. Example number 7, 6 and example number 5 you will do in your notebook. So today we finish 4 questions. Example 7, 6, 5 and question number 5, and also in question number 5 we will draw by frequency polygon. Thank you everyone. Have a nice day.